Hi viewer, I welcome you to Dream TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies, form 2, lesson number 20. The topic it is communication. I'm your tutor, Lucy Modoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson objectives today. We are going to discuss the factors that influence the choice of an appropriate means of communication. So, by the end of the lesson, there are going to discuss the factors that influence the choice of an appropriate means of communication, the right method of communication. How do you choose it? In our previous lesson, we have discussed the different means of communication, where we said that we can have the audiovisual communication, we can also have the written communication, we can also have the oral communications. So with that, how do you choose the best method for you to apply? Which is the best one? In oral communications, there is a number of them. In written communications, there are a number different means of communications that you can apply there. And the same, when it comes to the audiovisual, there is a number of means of communications that you can apply. So that is the reason as to why you have to look at the best method, how to choose it. How do I give the choice? One, it is the confidentiality. When we are looking at the advantages and disadvantages, there are some means of communications that we have said they don't offer the confidential, or they are not confidential. For example, when you are using the audio visual, it is not confidential. It cannot just release the message to the right person, but it can be passed to other people. Not like face to face. Not like the radio calls. So the confidentiality, it should be safeguarded, the content of the message from being accessed by unauthorized people. So that is something that you're supposed to consider. If at all that message it is confidential for that certain firm, then it means that it should not go outside that firm. So it should be confidential. You choose the right means of communication. Number two, accuracy of the means. Should be able to deliver the message in its original form without distortion. For example, when we talk about the oral communication, we said that the message does, when you are delivering the message using the oral communication, it means that message can be distorted. So when you want accuracy of your of the data, then it means you choose the right method. The right method that can preserve, that can reserve the accuracy. For example, the written documents. Remember, when you have used the written communication, it cannot be altered. It can't. Next, it is urgency of the message. How urgent is the message? For example, when we want to send a message that is so urgent, we cannot use the letters. You cannot just write. So you use or you take the one that is time conscious. This means should be fast enough to ensure timely delivery of the message, should reach the destination the right time. Number four, need for feedback. If at all, you need instant feedback, instant responses. You need to use the oral communication, verbal, telephone calls, the radio calls, you get immediate feedback. But for the written communication, you need to wait. Emails, someone can take weeks. Facts, the same. Messages, the same. Letters, the same. Then affordability of the meats. So it's readily available. Can you afford it? For example, when you talk about the fax, can you afford the machine that is used to send the fax? The sender must be able to meet the cost of the means so chosen. So you look at the cost. Number six, nature of the message. A combine of means could be chosen if the message is very complex. So you can combine the message. The way we read the message, we can put them, we can use a number of them. We can use verbal, written, everything in order for our message to be delivered appropriately. Number seven, need for future reference. Do you require future reference? Do you require to refer to that message? This means must be able to provide evidence if future reference would be required. For example, written documents, they are the best when it comes to that document, when it is required, that message, when you require future reference, rather than using the verbal communication. And eight, capacity of the mean. The mean should allow the required volume of information to be passed at an agreeable speed. So for you to choose it, it should allow the passage of the message. It can pass that message at that capacity. Number nine, reliability of the means. How reliable is that? That means of communication. The means should be able to deliver the information to the receiver as intended. Number 10, availability of the means. Is it readily available? I intend to use SMS. Does my receiver have a phone? I intend to use a fax. Does my receiver have that machine that can read the fax? I intend to use a letter. Does my receiver have the address? So all those things now you should be able to look at them. Use the readily available means of communication. Number 11, type or nature of audience or recipient. The means chosen should be appropriate or suitable to the needs of the audience. As it marks the end of the lesson, state four advantages of verbal communication. Outline four reasons why a business person may prefer written communication to verbal communication. I write four advantages of using Terex as a means of communication. If at all you want to refer, as you're answering the question, you can get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can get us from the Facebook. And you can also get us in Twitter. Stay tuned to Elim TV. Thank you.